What's up, everyone? So, there's going to be a little slideshow of our adventures at the end of the video, after the wrap-up. I just got out of the shower. Still at the hotel. Long story short, this weekend did not go as planned at all. And I'm not going to get into it, but we made the best of it. So, there's a couple people I'd like to thank here. We've had nothing but bad luck with car and tow and all this other stuff, but everyone we ran into in Pennsylvania and in Maryland have been nothing but nice and awesome and treated us, I don't know, like, with respect. It was, Jade and I were talking about it, it was like, I wish the whole world would be like these people. I mean, it was just, we were welcomed, they were just, they took care of us, is what they did. So, I'd like to thank Tammy for letting us metal detect her field, even though we didn't have enough time to actually do her field once the tow truck came. Thank you, Tammy. We wish we would have been able to spend a couple hours out there. Lance, our tow truck driver, was awesome. He not only towed the car, but he also packed up our stuff from the car, tied it up in the back of the truck, and drove us until we got a hotel room. So, Lance, if you ever watch this video, dude, I told you in person, you saved us, dude. You really did. We were totally prepared to spend the night out in the woods until we could figure out what we were going to do. Lance, thank you again. Kim, we are so happy we were able to find your dog. That made the trip for us. I mean, that was worth it, just to come down just for that. So, Kim, I hope you enjoy your puppy. It was cool. It was cool doing that. And finally, Jordan, the guy that Jason landed the permission in Maryland. Jordan, dude, thank you for having us. You were awesome. Thank you for the Mountain Dews. Thank you for just being cool, dude. You were awesome. So, without further ado, enjoy the video, guys. Have a good one. So we just got to Lititz, PA, and one of the permissions we kind of landed was a lady wanted us to find her dog. So Jay and I pulled up there, met the lady, real nice lady, showed us where the dog was at. We were there, what, 10 minutes digging? 5 minutes, maybe?
10 minutes from the time we pulled in the driveway and back out.
Yeah.
Second signal located it.
Yeah. Found her puppy. So she was happy. She start crying. I start crying because I'm a big old wuss. Can't help it. Love dogs. So I know what she's going through.
I avoided the situation, so I didn't start crying.
Yeah, I mean, it was pretty, I don't know. It was worth it coming out here just for that. So now we're on our way to a farm field where we're just going to wing it. We got permission here. We're going to drive 2 hours out to this place, detect out here, drive back, get a hotel room. So this is what it is. See ya at the farm field.
So I got an 8-inch 90 right here, and we tried to film it on the GoPro about
twice.
10 feet back that way. I got a 63 Washington. We are kind of just freelancing it in Maryland. Stuck in a hotel waiting for a ride back because the car broke down. So we just hoofed it on foot and we landed this permission. The guy wasn't sure how old the house was, possibly 1860s, but we Googled it and just got a generic 1900. So let's see what it is. And we've only been here
10 minutes. Yeah. I've been digging nothing but clad by the house.
I know it's down here.
I saw something.
Ain't what I was hoping it was. It's aluminum, big chunk of aluminum. Wah, wah.
So I'm at the front of the house. I was digging something that it's like an underground pipe. This took forever to find because I thought I was digging an underground pipe again, but this is a very ornate makeup compact. So if I get another tone like that, I will live dig it. I just assumed it was underground wire again. Let's see if I can get some of that details. I'm happy with that.
So I'm over here by the road. I already kind of cleaned it up. I found an older Tootsie toy. Still got all four wheels. So I did kind of ding it on the back here. But I think I'm going to offer it to the homeowner since he was so gracious to let us hunt here. I figure if he wants it, he can have it. I've got hundreds of Tootsies. So there it is.
So I had a jumpy 1720. I see it right here where my finger is. I'm gonna do a live reveal. I'm not exactly sure what it is, but I don't think it's garbage. To me, it kinda looks like a pocket knife. Yep. Pocket knife it is. Sweet. On a high tone here.
Oh, yeah, you.
Oh boy.
It's an ornate hinge.
That is awesome, dude. Oh, that's a beauty. Good find, Jason.
Explains why it was jumpy like that.
That rust? Good find. Look at that, guys. Wow. Good find, dude. No better. I should have live dug this. It's a Merc. Don't know what year it is. It's pretty damn hit. It'd be nice if it was a 1916D to pay for this trip.
Yeah.
But there it is.
So, as you can see, I'm over here. We're in the side yard. Ian found that Merc just about where I'm standing. And I just pulled a little aluminum thimble. I don't know if you can see that in the light. Here, I use Ian's head. Oh, I'm a little hat. I love Ian. I like sitting on his head. Whoa.
I'm leaving out there.
Ian says if I keep making fun of him, he's going to go home.
I'm going to walk home 600 miles.
Walk. Oh, got to love this, though. Awesome.
Says he's got a silver Washington, and if it's not a silver Washington, he's gonna walk home.
Oh man, better be a silver Washington. It's
94.95. Both.
I just said it's over Washington because you're digging up Mercs and crap over here. Top and deuces, people. Damn it, it's aluminum.
He's walking home, guys.
Crap. I'm fat. I need to.
In the backyard, There's lots of little scrap here. I found some loose pottery and scrap aluminum. Wasn't expecting to pull this, but this is ornate. See if I can clean this up a little bit. This is nice. Well, no, I think that's a hinge. But, I mean, that is cool. That should clean up real nice. Oh, look at the front. Oh, it's like all hollow, I think. I don't know. Sweet. And Jay is right in between the crotch of that tree. He likes being in between the crotch of the trees.
So I'm down here. I had a nice signal. And as you can see, I caught it right on the top. And it turns out to be some sort of like serving spoon thing. They call it a spade. But what I thought was interesting was that it was made right next to my thumb there. Maumee, Ohio. I don't know if you can read that. I can't see it in the screen, so. There we go. You know, go figure. Three states away. Find a spoon made in Ohio. Yep.
Alright, guys, so we're back at the hotel room, and, if you're watching this, long story short, we got stranded in Maryland. We were supposed to be hunting in Pennsylvania. So, without going into all the details, I'm just going to show what we found yesterday and today. Yesterday, I didn't find anything. Yesterday, Jason found this horseshoe and this knife. And you can't see it, but it says American knife. This is... I looked it up with that same little pattern on there. It's 1892 or 1862. So that's pretty good, pretty cool knife. I don't know if he found this. This might just been left over in his pouch, but that's pretty cool. Then today we hiked down about a mile to a house. Jason landed the permission. And the guys gave us permission. It was like a 1900 house. And he said that the guy that owns all the woods lives one house over. So I talked to him and we got permission to do the woods too. So here's today's hunt. Jason got a ornate hinge. Oh yeah, he got a, here we go. He found a silver quarter. Forgot to get this. 63. He found a Tootsie car there. He found this thing. This thing's pretty cool. It's huge. It says Farm Bureau. Not sure how old it is, but that's pretty cool. And I think that's about it. I found an ornate hinge as well. Now, these will look a lot better cleaned up. I found a pocket knife, but not as old as Jason's. I found a silver mercury dime and a couple pieces of porcelain and plate, but my find of the day is this compact. I'm holding it at an angle. It is super ornate, super cool. And if I had to guess, Jason's find of the 2 days is without doubt this thing. So guys, things didn't work out as planned, but Jay and I, we did the best we could. This is what it is. We leave here tomorrow. And, yeah. Thanks for watching. You know what to do. Like, subscribe. We're not going to be putting out as many videos as we'd like because we're just kind of taking a break from the hobby. So anyway, guys, thanks again for watching. See you next time.